if you look at this, then most genes, why do we refer to this as multiple alleles? Veelvuldige allele. En omdat, julle moet ook onthou, verlede week het ons gepraat van bloedgroepen as voorbeeld van co-dominantie. En vanaand praat ons ook daarvan as veelvuldige allele. En menselijke ABO bloed is een voorbeeld. It's an example of multiple alleles since we have four blood groups. If you can remember, it's A, B, AB, and O. And these four are all determined by three alleles on a single gene. Lorraine, jy het verlede keer hierdie vir hulle gewys.
Ja.
En prys 'n bietjie uit oor hierdie.
Goed, kyk, iets wat julle moet onthou, as wat Karel nou gesê het van veelvuldige allele. Elke geen het 'n alleel. Ons het laas gesê, gene kom in allele pare. So for each characteristic, you have two genes determining that characteristic. But with multiple alleles, you have a choice of more than two. Still, only two of them together will determine the characteristic. But you can have a choice. Let's have a look at our slide and see what we mean. Okay, here we have three alleles. Can I just have that? We've got three alleles, and our three alleles are A, B, and O. So now you have to have two of the three. Two A's, an A and an O, two B's, a B and an O, A, B, or O and O. Kyk net mooi na hoe ons het skryf, ons het verlede week ook hier oor gepraat. Die geen is I gemerk met de A. Nou, as twee A-gene by mekaar uitkom, dan is het bloedgroep A. A, so terloops, is ook een dominante geen. B is a dominant gene. So that is why we have co-dominance, where we have an A and a B together. And why we have blood group O, which is the recessive gene type O blood. Right, hope you understand this and remember from last week. But remember, it's also an example of multiple alleles. Goed, Colin, wat het ons hier?
As ons kyk na die volgende skyfie, sal julle ook sien weer soos wat Lorraine vir julle uitgelig het hier, dat dit meer as een allele is wat hierdie bloedgroep bepaal, sal jy sien, om nie te veel in te diep in te gaan nie, maar die antigeen, as iemand met bloedgroep A, daar die persoonse bloed kan slechts die antigeen A op die rooi bloedcellen identificeer. That is why a person with blood group A can give blood. Dit kan bloed skink aan A sowel as AB. Why to AB as well? Since AB, blood group AB, already has the antigen A, that means that a person with blood group A can give blood to a person with AB. But you can receive blood only from A and blood group O. And the same goes with B. But AB, if you look at blood group AB, the antigen, both antigens A and B, you will find on that red blood cells, which means they can only give blood to AB, but they can receive blood from A, because it has the antigen A, from B, because it has the antigen B, AB as well as O, which has no antigen. And of course, then you look at blood group O, they have no antigen on the red blood cells, but they can give blood to anyone. But they can only receive blood from O, since they have no antigen on it, and that is why they can't receive blood from anyone else than just O.
In other words, you will say that O is the universal donor, O can give to anybody, and AB is the universal receiver, AB can get from anybody.
Right. En as ons kyk na die volgende skyfie, sal jy sien, the question is, why can a person, and I think I've pointed that out to you now, that the lymphocytes, if a person with blood group B will receive blood from a person that has the antigen A, the lymphocytes will not recognize that antigen, and that person's lymphocytes will then destroy the new red blood cells that enter the body. So jy kan nie net vir enige persoon kan nie net bloed skenk of bloed gee vir iemand nie of ontvang van enige ander persoon nie.